First, he had to find Dustin something to do, something that would make him feel like he was part of the rescue effort. Sarah and Trish were at the other side of the campground. Someone had set up a trellis table in the shade of a small stand of gum trees. The two women were stacking boxes of food and water on the table and handing packages to the searchers who were getting ready to set out. Pete needed to start searching too, but there was something else he had to do first.
Come with me.
Dustin jumped down off the stairs. Pete felt a small hand slide into his, and he squeezed it as he led the boy across the campsite. Sarah saw him coming and smiled. That smile lifted the weariness of a long night from his shoulders.
Dustin, he said, this pretty lady is Sarah. Say hello to her.
Hello.
And this is Mrs. Warren. She's nice too.
Trish reached out to ruffle the boy's hair.
And I'm a pretty good cook. I think I may well have some home-baked cookies in one of these boxes, if you'd like one.
Dustin nodded.
Dustin wants to help in the search for his sister, Pete said.
Oh, thank goodness, Trish called on immediately. I really do need help. There's all this food and water to hand out to people. I need to be certain that everyone has some, including you, young man, and your mum and dad.
They're still asleep, Dustin offered. I think they were up all night hoping Renee would come home.
Pete caught Sarah's eye and saw the sympathy there.
I think we should let them sleep for a while longer, Trish said. Now, do you think you can help me get some more food from the car?
Yes.
Let's go then.
Trish and the boy moved off.
That was a very nice thing to do, Sarah said quietly. That poor boy. His parents must be out of their minds with worry.
I'd better get going now, Pete said.
I'll come with you.
You're not staying here with Trish.
No, I grew up around here. I know the country. I can be more use out there searching.